And now we will learn how a landlord or property owner would set up a company file. If you set up a file for your properties, QuickBooks assumes that all of the properties are in one company. For example, if you own three buildings and you make them an LLC, it means all three buildings have income that come into that company, and all the expenses for any of the buildings are expenses of that one company. That structure is what we're assuming here when you do the file setup. Creating a file in QuickBooks is somewhat similar to creating a file in most other software. In most other software, when you save the file, you choose the name and you choose the location of the file. However, with QuickBooks, the latest version of QuickBooks, or at least QuickBooks Windows, does not let you choose the location. After you create the file, you have to search around the computer using the search bar to find the location of the file. It's not as convenient as it can be, but that's the way it is. After we do that, we will skip inputting the company information and tax information because that's part of setting up the file, and we'll skip it for now. And then at the end of the video, I'll come back and I'll show you how you can change the company name and address in the file, and you can change the tax type. So let's take a look at how we're going to do this. Just like, well, let me just fit this into our little show. And just like with any other software, when you create a new file, you can go to the top left and click File, New, and that would be the same thing as clicking this button here, Create New Company. If you happen to be in a screen with no company open, you can click either. But if you're in a screen where the company is already open, no problem. You will still have a file menu on the left, and you can click New Company. Now, we get the Express Start over here. We get the Express Start window. Just click Express Start. Now, for company name and address, it's very simple. We're only going to put the name for now. Holden, well, you can make it in caps because I like to distinguish between what we put and what QuickBooks put. So we'll put in caps Holden, which is the guy's name, the landlord. And this is the owner of the property. Now, for industry type, click Help Me Choose, scroll all the way down, and then click Other None. Then click OK. This is because we don't want QuickBooks to put a sample chart of accounts for us. We want to put the accounts ourselves. And the way to do that is to choose Other None. For business type, we'll put that in later. For now, click Help Me Choose, and we'll click Other None. And we'll come back later and tell QuickBooks what business type we are, and click OK. In a real situation, we would fill in the address and the zip and the state and so forth. But as I said, I'm going to show you how to edit these momentarily. So when you're done with that, when you're done with the screen, all you have to do is click Create Company, and physically QuickBooks will be creating a brand new blank company file for you to put in all your company information and manage your business. Now, this window that pops up, you can either click Start Working or you can click the X in the top right. And here we are. Now, as soon as you create any file in any version of the QuickBooks Windows desktop, you have a whole bunch of windows that open up. You just click Close, you get a lot of help, click Close, you get a lot of messages and nonsense and this and that. But don't worry about the information we skipped over when we created the file. You can change the company name and address as well as the tax type by opening the My Company window. So let's take a look. From the main menu, click Company, My Company. This is the place where you would change the information we just put in. Now, there's a pencil on the top right that allows you to edit not only the name, but other things like the legal name as well as the tax type. So we click the pencil tool, and you can see that I have already off camera typed in the address, but you can click here and you could type in the address or whatever else it was that you skipped, you know, 1737 Meadow Lane, Hopog, New York, whatever it is you want to put. So that's the contact information, and whatever you type into this field here will be the address that shows up on all the forms and the reports when you print company forms and company reports in QuickBooks. You can change the legal information, the company ID. Normally they would have a company employer identification number and so forth. Or if you were a sole proprietor, you would use your social, and that's where you would put in and change that information there. Now, most importantly, you can click report information. When you click report information, you're telling QuickBooks which tax form, which means you're telling QuickBooks what company type your company is. And of course, you can put other none if you don't have a company. If you're just a person who owns a house and rents three or four units in your house, you can put other none. But if you set up the ownership of your properties as a company, probably one of these forms is appropriate. So just click OK, and then just click No, and now you know how to change the information we skipped over when we created the file. Now, in the recent versions of QuickBooks for Windows, they do not tell you where the file is physically located. The only way to find out where the file is after you created it is to press F2 when QuickBooks is in front of you and QuickBooks is the active window. You will get the location of the file as well as other information about the file. So, if I'm in QuickBooks and I go to my keyboard and I push F2, I get this window popping up, the product information window. It has a lot of information about the software that's installed on the computer, as well as the file you just created. You'll notice the license number and product number up here are blurred out or blocked out for illustration purposes, but normally it would say the license number and the product number of the software you bought. You could see a lot of other information about the file, but the most important information is here, the location or the path. Now, we don't know where this is. Turns out that it looks like QuickBooks did put this on the desktop. So I know that the new file I created called Holden the Landlord is now on the desktop. But if I didn't know where it was, I could highlight this entire row after location, right click and click copy. Then I could go to the bottom where the folder is for Windows Explorer, click into the folder bar and paste, and QuickBooks would show me. You have to chop off the name of the file and just get the last name of the folder. So if I come here and I hit enter, now I'm seeing everything in the folder that the file is in. And if I scroll a bit, if I bring it over here and scroll a bit, you can see that Holden the Landlord, the file is in fact in this path that I copied from the QuickBooks when I pushed F2 and got the product information.